did I mention, Martin might have said, that the focus is artifice and replication and the case is plastic trees? What's wrong with this plan, right? And he intends to actually submit it to science. But what we first have to note about Martin is that he has an unerring, almost uncanny ability to identify the key works. So we might be talking about regional economies. 2 weeks later, Martin will come back and tell me about Bill Cronin's Nature's Metropolis. Right? I mean, he just goes right to the key text. Tree huggers were an inspiration for the ecology movement, which we've been hearing about in terms of Dan's work, and 1970 is the first Earth Day. Right, so all this is sort of percolating around in Berkeley as well.
My contribution to the discussion is to talk and to link Martin's research with his pedagogy. So for me, this is part of the challenge of us as scholars. We can all look, but can we see? And fundamentally, can we bring our knowledge and understanding to change the world and to change the pictures? And I think Martin's work has helped us to do this in a couple of different ways. Martin asks us to think more deeply about the natural environment and what we value. Should we see Niagara Falls? How should we see Niagara Falls? Is it a monument, an event, a show to be directed by experts? As individuals and as a society, we've different responses to that question, but as scholars of policy and planning, we have an obligation to weigh alternatives. And as we move forward, I hope we think of this deeply ethical engagement with the seen, everyday world, and I hope that remains a feature of our work at Price.
I'm sure there are many emails that came before my time at Price, but I think those just sort of give a sense of Martin as a kind of humanist in the most sort of capacious and generous understanding of the world, someone who put people first and was always concerned about their sort of central role in all of the work and scholarship that he did, including in the emails that he sent out.
What's wonderful about universities is we can actually see and then continuously retune what we think about that. And that's what great policy schools do. The Price School of Public Policy really has earned the public trust. And because you come up with policies that and practices and thought processes that result in improving our lives, and I like this concept of public service, that this is the place that we think about the society around us and put in place the practices that lead to a higher quality lifestyle for us all, mitigate the disparities that we're seeing and improve lives for everyone. So congratulations to everyone here. I look forward to another 90 years.